Hello Blender users, I am Bhagat and welcome to my channel. I am going to show you how to make an animation like this. Let's open Blender, delete everything except the cube and change this cube shape to a skyscraper. Go to edit mode, select the top face and move it on the z-axis. Add a plane, scale it with S and press 25. Alright, to make a twisting building, go to modifiers and select the simple deform modifier. We have to twist it on the z-axis, so select Z. Change the angle to 140 degrees. Because it has no geometry, it looks weird. So go to edit mode and add some edge loops. Okay, now it's looking good. Apply shade smooth, go to normals and enable auto smooth. Looking good so far. Add a subdivision surface modifier, choose simple and change it to 3. Go to render preview. There is no light. Let's add an environment texture and choose your favorite texture according to your mood. I'm choosing this texture. I will provide this HDRI link in the description. Now let's add texture to our model. Go to shader editor and add brick texture. Connect it to the base color. Our model is not UV unwrapped. It is using generated in the texture coordinate. Let me show you. Select the texture and press Ctrl D on your keyboard. See, it is taking from the generated. Let's change it to UV. We did not unwrap our model, so the texture is stretching. Go to edit mode. Select everything by pressing A and press U. Smart UV project. Click OK. Looking good. Decrease the offset to 0 to make straight lines. And change the gray color from here. Just place your mouse on the white color and press Ctrl C to copy the color. And move your mouse and paste it here with Ctrl V. Okay, now scale the texture. Make it 25. Now it is in the rectangle shape. So scale the row height to 0.7. Looks fine. Now add color. You can add color here, but I'm going to use the color ramp. And make it like a glass color. Like blue. And make it dark. Alright, looks fine. Now add another color ramp for roughness. And connect the brick texture. Here you can see the smoothness is happening on the black lines, but we want smoothness on glasses. So flip the color ramp. Now glasses are smooth, but we want some extra smoothness. Bring down the black color in the color ramp. Now it's looking good. But the model is very flat, so add some bump here. Add bump node and also add a color ramp. Connect the brick texture to the factor, color to the height and normal to normal. Now we have some bumps on our model. I'm decreasing the strength and distance. Looks fine. Now close the shader editor and add a camera. Press 0 to view from the camera. Go to cycles render. Let's hide our plane for now. And press Ctrl Alt 0 to place your camera where you are looking at right now. Now change the dimension to x1080 and y1920. We just want to render only the area where the camera is using. So press Ctrl B and drag it with the left mouse button. Alright, let's add another model without the twist. Select the model, Shift D to copy and place it next to it. Remove the simple deform modifier. Okay. Now to animate this, press the Shift plus tilde key. It is below of escape button. And now you have the luxury to move your camera freely. W to move forward, S to backward, A to move left, D to move right, Q for down and E for up, just like game controllers. Now let's animate it. You already know this auto keying, right? It will automatically insert the keyframes while we making any changes. Now go to frame 1 and enable auto keying. By the way, when we are moving our camera, when it completes the frame 250, it will start again from the beginning. And the auto keying will replace our keyframes from the frame 1. And we don't want to do that. So increase the frames with a big number like 1000. Let's bring our model down. I think we don't need the floor, so delete it. I'm going to move my camera like this to imitate that I'm recording it from a smartphone. Alright. Let's put our camera here. Okay. When we press the play button, the keys are going to add here when we move our camera. Go to frame 1 and whenever we press the space bar, immediately I'm going to press the Shift plus tilde shortcut to move the camera. Okay, click the space bar. Now click the shortcut key, move camera for a while and stop whenever you feel enough. By the way, if you are using a low end PC, animate it in the EV render so it will play smoothly. Okay, now stop our animation and don't forget to disable the auto keying. Alright, we created some keyframes. We don't want anything from here. Let's see where our animation is stopping. And set the frame number here, 320. To see our animation, go to AV to play it smoothly. We don't want to see this area, so select the camera and go to camera properties and in the viewport display increase it to 1. Now we can't see this area. Now go to frame 1. There are no frames in the beginning, so let's move the keyframes. Select everything with A and move to the left by pressing G. Right here. Also, there are no frames here. So, change the frame number to where our keys ended, 270. Now, let's play the animation. Okay, looks good. But you can see the camera is not moving smoothly. To fix this, go to graph editor. You can see there are no frames in between, so the camera is not moving smoothly. Go to key and select sample keyframes. We joined our keys. Now let's make the camera movement softer. Again go to key. Here you can see smooth keys and its shortcut is Alt O. We smoothed the keys, but it is not enough. Press Alt a few times in the graph editor to make it smooth. Alright, let's see our animation. It is very smooth now. By the way, in the output properties, change the frame rate to 30. And remember these settings. We need them when we edit our image sequence. Let's render it and see how it looks. Sorry. Let's render somewhere around here. And add some motion blur to it to make it realistic. Enable motion blur and decrease the shutter to 0.1. There are a lot of samples. Change the sample in the render properties. I am using 80 samples for now. Enable denoise. Looks perfect. When I'm editing this video, I saw these lines are not straight in the corner. To fix this, you can just scale the brick texture in the shading. And lighting is a little less. Increase the lighting to 1.5. And I need a bright blue sky. So let's go to shader editor and change it to world. And add a hue saturation node in between and bring the saturation to 1.5. I think it's too much. 1.2. Looks perfect. By the way, if you don't like the sky, you can change the HDRI location. Select the texture and press Ctrl T. And in the rotation, change the Z value. I'm not going to change it. Let's render it. Enable use nodes. Add a viewer node to view the render image. Press V to zoom out, Alt V to zoom in. I already made a video on this. You can watch it in the Blender Simple Task playlist. Hold Shift and drag it with the right mouse to connect two nodes. Add lens distortion. This is to make some imperfections to make our video look real. Make it to 0.02. Alright, looks fine. Distort minus 0.01. Now add glare. Did you notice the change? And if you need to change the color, you can do that with the color balance node. But I'm not going to use it. Now let's render it. Go to output properties and I'm going to save them on the desktop. I'm making a new folder with some numbers. And click accept. Render animation. Okay, I'm canceling the render because I have an image sequence from my last render. Don't forget to save the project. These are the images from the video which I showed in the beginning. So to make a video, open Blender, video editing, press Shift A, image sequence, open the folder. Now select everything with A and add them. Now change the dimension, x1080, y1920. And I don't have any idea why our video is not fitting in this. Let me scale it. Actually, I use Premiere Pro to edit my videos. And change the frame rate to 30 fps. The frames are stopping at frame 250, but we rendered more than that. So see what is the last frame and change it at the bottom. Now choose the folder where you want to save the video. File format FFmpeg, encoding set as it is, but change the output quality, make it high. That's it. Now render the animation. Render animation. Alright, looks perfect. That's it for this video. Subscribe to watch more content from me. Thanks for watching.